Today on Bike People, we're riding on the mighty Mississippi. Forrest dreams big.
We guys love our toys.
Lean back.
And Suzette rides a different kind of two-wheeler. All that and more straight ahead on Bike People. Bike People, brought to you in part by CatTrike, focusing on the design, engineering, and manufacturing of innovative recumbent trikes that are made in the USA. The Hotel Pattee, a cycling hub for the High Trestle and Raccoon River Valley Trail, a destination unto itself for Iowa adventures. The Hotel Pattee. Bike World, the store that supports the sport, serving cyclists since 1979. Additional consideration provided by Shimano, Winnebago, Bike Iowa.
My name is Forrest. I got my first bike at age 3. My next bike at age 7. I've ridden in Europe, Australia, and all across our great nation.
My name is Suzette. I'm a mom, TV personality, and bike lover. I've known Forrest for years from interviews, rides, and bike events.
I'm in the bicycle business and a cycling enthusiast. I've been collecting, fixing, and selling bikes my whole life.
We love bikes and all the people, stories, and adventures around them.
It's all downhill, right?
We're on a journey to show you the world through two wheels. Yeah!
To help you become
bike people. Welcome to this week's episode of Bike People. Today we're in the Quad Cities, which spans both sides of the Mississippi River.
Today we visit a family who's been serving up sweets for over 100 years.
Best $25 your grandfather probably ever spent.
I think so.
See if we can master a different way of getting around.
Put the weight on your heels, you go backwards. Put the weight on your toes, you go forward.
And explore a local legend that offers some surprising things to do.
Well, I think it's time to go ride for a little while. I've got something special to show you.
Great, let's roll.
The Riverfront Trail is 7.6 miles long, including a loop around Credit Island. It offers a scenic view of the Mississippi River and connects numerous parks and recreational facilities throughout Davenport. On the east end, it continues as the Bettendorf Riverfront Trail, traveling by other landings and points of interest along the way.
So this is west of the city on Credit Island, where bike paths and the street run together sometimes.
It's a great place to ride. There's hardly any traffic, and the views are gorgeous.
Ooh, that is a good view.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
A lot of bridges.
The Riverfront Trail is also part of the American Discovery Trail, a coast-to-coast non-motorized recreation trail covering more than 6,800 miles across 15 states.
Trees, water, warm weather, sun, bike trail, bicycle. What more do you need?
How about ice cream?
Now you're talking.
Absolute favorite stop of the entire trip, Lago Marcino's ice cream. I am so excited.
Well, I told you I had something really special planned after a good long day's ride like today. So here it is.
That's right, and we are here with the owner. Good to see you.
Good to see you too. Welcome. Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, we're excited because I love ice cream. We were chatting earlier and you said that when you're in Italy, you love gelato, and I love ice cream. That's good Midwestern fare. So we're excited. Tell us what are you famous for?
We're famous for our hot fudge sundae. And we make our ice cream, we make our hot fudge. My grandfather bought the recipe for the hot fudge for $25. My grandmother was horrified that he spent that much money. But it's the best
proven
investment.
To be a good investment.
Good investment, yeah.
You have quite a history here in the Quad Cities. Tell us a little bit about that.
We do. This is our 106th year in business.
Good for you.
I'm third generation. I run it with my brother and my sister. Our key is that we don't change. And I think in our fast-paced society, people relish something that hasn't changed. It's the same as it was in their childhood. It's the same as it was in their grandparents' childhood.
Well, let's have somebody whip something up for us.
Okay, we will, we will. I think we're gonna have my daughter do that.
Now, Beth, this looks incredible. And I also understand you have a kind of a special system where you've removed the calories.
Yes.
And you've replaced them with?
Energy units, which every bicyclist needs.
That's so. Right.
I like it. No calories, just energy units.
Yeah.
Love it.
Okay.
We're excited.
Time to energize.
Great investment. Best $25 your grandfather probably ever spent.
I think so.
Very good. Well, I don't want to push you too fast, but we need to kind of hurry up here. I've got something else special planned for you. It does involve two wheels.
It does.
I think you'll enjoy it.
And will we be burning off some energy units?
A few. Not as many as before, but a few.
All right, let's finish up.
I told you now I had something great planned. It involved two wheels.
Yep.
We can burn off a little of those energy units.
Yep.
This is our friend Cole here.
Awesome. Good to see you, man.
Cole is going to teach you and I how to ride the Segway.
Yes.
Yay.
It's very simple.
I like simple.
Everybody does. It's literally as easy as if you could stand up straight, you can ride a Segway. Okay?
How did you make it a business?
When all the big corporations here have team building events, they send their people to us during their lunch hour to go out and get a Segway tour of the area and to be able to do a team building event at the same time. When we do a full tour, a 2-hour tour, you can see 17 miles of the riverfront in 2 hours.
Beautiful.
And that'd be hard pressed to walk. Put the weight on your heels, you go backwards. Put the weight on your toes, you go forward, okay? When you want to steer left or right, hands on the handlebar. If you want to go to the right, you push to the right. If you want to go left, you push to the left. Okay? Don't look down, don't go backwards, don't hit each other, don't hit curbs, cars, or people, you'll be fine. That's a 5-minute summary in about 30 seconds.
Curbs, cars, people. Curbs, car. Okay. Ready.
Anything not flat, I'm not
gonna do. Toes, I can feel it through the handlebar. Heels. Toes. This is what happens if you go backwards. Don't go backwards. Okay.
Okay. Here, let's circle. Let's circle like we're circling, you know?
Circle of wagons?
Yeah, circling wagons. This will be like, we got our own little merry-go-round. I'm gonna get you, Forrest. I'm gonna get you.
Just follow me. You'll know what I'm talking about. Cool? Any questions?
With everybody all trained up, it's time to head out for a little tour. Our first stop is Riverfront Park, longtime home of the historic Bix Beiderbecke Memorial Jazz Festival.
This is Bix Beiderbecke Memorial, if you will. This is the band shell. It was built in 1924, or erected in 1924. All the artwork on it is original, except for the paintwork. They have to repaint it every year.
The Segway was a fun way to get around. It was easy to learn how to use, and you could see so many things from it.
This is Lock and Dam number 15. There's 21 dams on the Mississippi River from north to south, or this is east to west right here. This is the only 40-mile stretch of the Mississippi from LeClaire down to Muscatine that runs east to west, not north to south. This is the largest roller dam in the world. You can get tours of the dam. The towers that are in between each one, you can go up there and actually they'll take you up there and so you can look in there. It's really cool. The red that you see on top rolls up and down to let the water flow through. So it's like a mouth that opens up to let the water flow through.
You know, the Segway is a lot like riding a bicycle. Two wheels, wind in your hair, sun in your face. This was a lot of fun.
Just off the Riverfront Trail in Davenport is the Hotel Blackhawk, a historic landmark that has been painstakingly returned to its original 1915 splendor.
All right, first things on my list, spa.
Figures. We'll all check out the rest of the hotel. Have fun.
All right, see you later.
With me today is Amy and Amrit Gill. They're the owners of the Blackhawk Hotel. And we'd like to maybe learn a little bit more about your hotel and kind of the passion that you have for it here.
We were invited by the city of Davenport to come and look at the hotel. It had been vacant for over 6 years.
It was hard not to fall in love with this elegant lady, because that's what it is. That's not what it looked like when we walked through. There was a ceiling about 10 feet above our heads that was all the way across. The skylight was gone, that we're sitting under.
This lobby was so dark and claustrophobic almost, because that floor was there. And it was just so needed somebody to love it and fix it.
And recreate the gold room the way the gold room used to look when this building was built.
What is so magnificent today was just a terrible dungeon of space
exactly.
A number of years ago. Where did you have to go to find all of the beautiful craftsmanship, architecture, the product that you put into this labor of love, as you put it?
All over the world.
The original people who did the work in this hotel did it with Iowa in mind. So the plaster work in the gold room actually reflects the state of Iowa. The little round flower that's in the plaster work is the state flower of Iowa. There's oak leaves, which is the tree of Iowa. There's all the
corn
things that are corn, which is obviously grown in Iowa.
Corn flower.
So everything in that plaster work had something to do with Iowa, except one thing, which is the pineapple, which is a symbol of hospitality. It's really interesting to us. The plasterers that we brought in from all over the place are really old style craftsmen. Where the plaster had fallen off or gone into disrepair, they made molds. They remade all this plaster work. All this plaster work along here is all remade from the original.
Including above your head. All that plaster work was redone because it had all been chipped out, literally, during that 70s renovation.
Well, just like the pineapple, we really appreciate all of your great hospitality for having us here for this great event and this beautiful facility. So thank you so very much.
You're very welcome.
You're very welcome.
In addition to the normal hotel amenities, Forrest and Suzette find several unique ways to keep occupied.
He's a good-looking dog.
Not bad, not bad.
Remember when I beat you last time bowling?
I remember when I beat you last time bowling, yes.
All right, time for a rematch. Let's go.
Let's go.
That was excellent. Here we go. Winner.
Oh, no.
Ah!
This is going to be ugly. Oh, that hurts. You won.
98-117.
Okay, I was just getting warmed up, but I think this next game is for all the tea in China.
Well, there's one way to make a great day into an awesome day, and that is winning. Mm.
Well, we did play two games, and I did
did win the second one by a substantial margin, but nonetheless, it was a great day, and tomorrow we've got some fun rides planned. So go get your beauty sleep, and we'll see you in the morning.
I'm out of here.
Good morning. It's day two for us here in the Quad Cities, and we are on the other side of the river in Illinois today and looking forward to a fantastic ride.
Well, we're just north of the Quad Cities in Port Byron, Illinois, right in the middle of a 62-mile stretch of the Great River Trail. 70 degrees and sunny, perfect day for a bicycle ride.
With both paved paths and shared road sections, the Great River Trail offers outstanding views of the Mississippi River and the small river towns along the way.
See, that statue we saw earlier was a penny farthing. Have you ever been on one of those?
I've ridden a penny farthing. In fact, I've got a friend that has ridden a penny farthing across the United States.
Wow, I can't even ride my road bike across the United States.
Oh, sure you could.
Great River Trail is also part of the Grand Illinois Trail, a 500-mile-long collection of trails that loop between Lake Michigan and the Mississippi River, featuring everything from classic Chicago neighborhoods to historic canals and picturesque small towns. Stopping at four locations, the Channel Cat Water Taxi allows cyclists an easy way to cross the river or enjoy a scenic ride along what was once considered the most dangerous section of the Upper Mississippi River. It's also likely you'll spot some of the river wildlife along the way.
Why do they call it Channel Cat?
They have a whisper. They have a whisper.
All right, I think we're ready to roll.
Are you staying on? Okay, all right.
Good to see you guys.
Located right on the Great River Trail, the John Deere Pavilion is visited daily by families and tour groups from all over the world.
Hey Dad, are you watching? You're gonna be so jealous because I am at the John Deere Pavilion in Moline, Illinois, and I'm here with Bridget. Thanks for having us.
Thank you for coming.
Well, Bridget, tell us a couple things about this area. Plus, tell me when I can try out some of this equipment. It's cooler than my bike, and I have a really cool bike.
Yeah, this is actually taking you longer to get on the equipment here, stopping and talking to me, but the pavilion here is Deere & Company's free visitor center attraction for John Deere. You'll learn everything that there is to know about John Deere right here in the pavilion.
Nice.
Awesome. And I see that you have some brand new tractors flanked by some very old tractors that I remember. Not that I'm that old, but I do remember my dad having some older tractors.
Yes, yes. We have vintage equipment on display. And we also have new products, so you can get up right into that cab and start driving. We are here in Moline because right across the street is where Deere had his very first factory. Also in Moline is Deere & Company, the world headquarters. We host something that's surprising, exciting, engaging for everyone in the whole family. So it can range from everything that we have here at the pavilion. They can also make tours for reservations at our factory.
So. Awesome.
Well, I'm ready to get engaged, like right now.
All right, let's get you behind the wheel and pretend you're driving.
Let's go. We guys love our toys, and these are some fun, big toys here.
They are gigantic. I can't believe the variety in this place. You know, a girl's gotta make it run too.
One of the most unique landmarks in the Quad Cities is the Government Bridge, a 1,600-foot double-decker bridge that accommodates trains above, cars below, and includes a separated cyclist pedestrian area. Forrest and Suzette are heading over to Arsenal Island, which has its own trail as well as many other points of interest.
And the railroad was represented by Abraham Lincoln.
Well, one of the last stops is going to be an educational and fun one. So I'm here with Eric today, and where are we?
Welcome to Rock Island Arsenal. You are at Rock Island Arsenal, which is the Army's arsenal and home, a logistics hub for servicing a mission around the world. Where we're standing right now is the site of the original military installation that was put here in 1816. The fort was turned into an arsenal in 1863. We celebrated the 150th anniversary just 2 years ago. During the Civil War, it was a POW camp for Confederate prisoners of war. We still have a Confederate cemetery with more than 960 grave markers marking the Confederate soldiers who passed on here during the Civil War. You know, really the first thing you should see when you get here, though, is the lock and dam, which is still an ongoing lock and dam operated by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, which has a wonderful visitor center that I can show you as the first stop on the island.
Fantastic. Well, let's go there.
Thanks.
Well, you're at the visitor center for the lock and dam system for the Mississippi River. This is run by the Corps of Engineers Rock Island District. And what it does is control navigation up and down the river, and in all reality, across the river as well. The Corps of Engineers is responsible for locks and dams all the way up and down the river from more than 100 miles north of here all the way to St. Louis, where the river opens up enough that the lock and dam structure isn't required. We operate a bridge that rotates 360 degrees to allow barge traffic to go through. We work with the Corps of Engineers to keep traffic going in both directions. Inside here is the Corps of Engineers Visitors Center. It explains the history of the construction of the lock and dam, things about wildlife on the river, how the lock and dam structure works, and the function of barge traffic and its importance to the U.S. economy.
Eric, we're ready to hop on the bikes. Where should we meet you next?
Meet me down at the Colonel Davenport House. It's a historic site that's important to the history of the Quad Cities and to Rock Island Arsenal.
Sounds good.
Awesome.
Let's go.
Yeah, let's roll.
We're standing in front of the Colonel Davenport home. Now, the home was built in 1833 by Colonel George Davenport. He was a prominent businessman in the area. He traded with Indians up and down the river for furs and was the sutler or supply for the Army base when the Army base was still functional here. The legend is that Anton LeClaire, who founded Davenport, named the city after his best friend, George Davenport, and that they would come out and onto each other's front porches and wave at each other across the river every day.
See, there's guys fishing. I bet they're catching fish.
I bet they are.
There you go.
Yeah.
So, Eric, this is a beautiful home. Who actually lives here?
Well, now no one actually lives here. From the 1870s, when the home was built, until the mid to early 2000s, about 2007, it was the commander's residence for whichever person was commanding Rock Island Arsenal. The upkeep on it became just too high. It was going to cost millions of dollars to bring it into modern code. And so it was taken out of the residential registry. When it was a residence, it was the second largest home at 22,000 square feet in the federal registry. As you look around the home and really around the arsenal as a whole, you'll see things like the wrought iron fence that surrounds quarters one. All of the metal in those ornamental pieces is melted down ordnance from the Civil War that was melted down and then reused in the foundry right here at the arsenal and is of local manufacture. So quarters one has beautiful front porch lintels that are actually literally made from cannon barrels, and filigree that is melted down horseshoes and melted down cannonballs from the Civil War. Those make up a lot of the ornamental aspects here on the island of all of its architecture.
Well, in case we don't see you a little bit later, Eric, thank you so much. You are a wealth of information, and I hope that a lot of people come out and check this out.
Well, thanks very much. Yeah. Come back anytime.
Great. Thanks, Eric. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
This is really a unique place where you've got armaments all the way from the Civil War up to current day.
It is really fascinating, but they don't let you ride them like they do at the John Deere Pavilion.
After riding all over the island this afternoon, we finally made it to the museum.
We saved the best for last.
Opened to the public in 1905, the Rock Island Arsenal Museum is the Army's second oldest museum. Nationally recognized for its extensive small arms collection, it also chronicles the history of the military equipment made by the arsenal.
You gotta be in heaven in this place, Forrest.
Everything from handguns to cannons, it's a paradise for guys.
And check it out, there's clothing for us girls too.
This is not a gift shop.
Wow, what an amazing first day. We had ice cream at world-famous Lago Marcinos. We went on a Segway ride and stayed at the historic Black Hawk Hotel.
Well, day number two is incredible. We got to ride a Channel Cat, ride some big John Deere equipment, and in a very informative tour of the Rock Island Arsenal. There's so many more things that we didn't get to see. This is a great place to come and visit.
For more information about all the things that we did, go to bikepeople.tv and remember to get on out there and become
bike people.
Energy units. I wonder how many energy units are in this one.
I would say you could bike all day long.
I will. This will be what I need for tomorrow then.
Exactly.
Carb loading for tomorrow. Exactly. I love it. Mm-hmm.
I think I might be the only person that doesn't get it to stop shaking at first.
No, piece of cake. Piece of cake.
I can tell you the heavier you are, the longer it takes.
No, it'll take me an hour and a half and then I'll know.
This is gonna be fantastic. I can't wait.
Bike People, brought to you in part by CatTrike. Focusing on the design, engineering, and manufacturing of innovative recumbent trikes that are made in the USA. The Hotel Pattee, a cycling hub for the High Trestle and Raccoon River Valley Trail, a destination unto itself for Iowa adventures. The Hotel Pattee. Bike World, the store that supports the sport. Serving cyclists since 1979. Additional consideration provided by Shimano, Winnebago, Bike Iowa,